Amen. There's a time and a place to rest, isn't there? Amen. It's right here in the presence of the Lord. Amen. We have a little girl that wouldn't take a nap this afternoon, so she's napping now. Really not the time to take her nap. Amen. But she's learning. We're all learning, right? We'll need her to rest. And this is really where our rest is found, in the presence of God. Amen. I feel God. And Brother David, you started where my text is going to start. Not what I'm going to preach on, but where I'm going to start. Amen. 2 Kings chapter number 4. Probably one of my favorite passages in the Old Testament. I love Elisha and Elijah. I appreciate these men. And so I'm going to look at the Word of God maybe in a little bit of a different way tonight than what we sometimes look. No, down here is all right tonight. Amen. I just want to share some things. Keep your Bibles open. We're going to walk through this. I'm going to jump to Hebrews a little bit later. But I'm going to look at what the Word of God says. We find the miracle of the man of God. Elisha, remember the creditors have come to take away the widow woman's sons because there was debt. That's the way it worked. Her husband was a good man, was a prophet, pleased God. And we know how that Elisha came to shut the doors up, God provided. Oh, thank God for the times we just shut the doors up. Doesn't matter how many is behind the door, amen, it takes men and women who want to see a move of God's presence and God pours out of the Holy Ghost. Amen? Praise God. And so we find that Brother David started reading, and it fell on a day that Elisha passed to Shunem, where was a great woman, and she was constrained him to eat bread. And it was so that as often as he passed by, he turned in thither to eat bread. Here was this woman being a great woman. When we read about her being great, probably a very wealthy woman. And one thing that she didn't allow to get in her way was her wealth. But the Bible says that this wealthy woman, she constrained the man of God, "Come by my house." And she said to her husband after Elisha has passed by, she said, "Honey, Elisha is a man of God. And I want to build a little room on our house that when he passes by, that he can stop, Sister Nancy. He can lay his head. We'll put a bed, we'll put a table, a candlestick, stool, everything he needs in there. And when he passes by, we will take care of him." And Brother David, you said that well tonight. If I could just go a little bit further on that. You know, we often think sometimes about doing things to allow God to work and move in our life. Whether it's that we're faithful in our Bible reading, we're faithful in our prayer, we're faithful in our attendance to church, whatever it is, faithful in taking care of other people. I want to tell you something, that when we allow a little room for God, we allow great room for God to bless and minister in our life. We don't do it for that, but God will bless us. You make room for God, amen, and what God will do in your life will be so much greater than what you ever anticipated God doing for you. Amen. I'm going to tell you tonight, even in this service, if you make room for God to work and move in your heart tonight, amen, taking the Word of God, finding yourself in prayer, amen, it's no telling what God will do for you. He will meet your needs, amen, beyond what your expectation could ever be. Probably beyond things that you're even expecting, God will work and move in your life. Mm-hmm. That's who God is. And the Bible says, let's make a little chamber, a room, I pray ye in the wall. Let us set for him there a bed, a table, a stool, a candlestick. And it shall be when he comes to us that he shall turn him hither, making room for God. And it fell on the day that he came thither, and he turned into the chamber. And there he said to Gehazi's servant, "Call the Shunammite." And when he had called her, she stood before him. I won't read all of this, amen, word for word, but he said, "Listen, when she comes by, ask of her, what is it that we can do for her?" What is it that we can do for you? Will we be able to speak to you, to the king, and maybe have you a little place there? What do you want? Oh, no, I don't want to do that. I love my own people. And so the Bible says that she went out, and all of a sudden Gehazi said, hey, well, if she doesn't have any suggestions, maybe I can make a suggestion. Her husband's older. What that has to do with anything? I mean, you can be older than kids, right? Amen. What that has to do with anything? She's older, and so maybe that she would like to have a child. So we know the story goes on that they call her back in, and the man of God speaks to her and says about this season, according to the time of your life, you shall embrace a son. And she said, no, my Lord, the man of God, do not lie to your handmaid. You know what she was saying? She was saying, don't get my expectations high and let them down. Who likes to have their expectations built way up and you're expecting something only to free fall to find that they never come to pass? And so, Brother David, she didn't want the man of God to tinker around. Yes, I trust you. I believe you. I believe you're a man of God. But don't get my expectations high. I want to tell you tonight in the sanctuary, when we trust and we believe God, and when we hear from God, and when we read the Word of God, God will never let us down our expectations. Amen. God is big enough to take care of you and God. Amen. The God who's able to cast our seed, amen, as far as the east is from the west. A God who's able to hear every cry of our heart. A God who promises us that He'll be with us unconditionally, that He'll hold our hand. He'll whisper in our ear, there's nothing to fear. I'm going with you. When you wait upon me, I'll renew your strength. I'll give you the ability to make it. Let me tell you what, God will never, ever, ever let us down. Amen. I believe God is here tonight to tell you that He is for you and He is with you. Amen. He wants to bring revival. He wants to fill with the Holy Ghost. He wants to do greater things. I believe that, Brother David. There are greater things. We feel the presence of God. No matter how many He's here, no matter what service it is, we always feel the presence of God when we are here. But it's not just enough. There is more. Amen. God will never let us down. The Bible says in verse number 17 that the woman conceived and bore a son at that season that Elisha had said unto her, according to her time of life. You know what? According to her time of life, you know what the Word of God is saying? It's a miracle. Brother Josh, her time of life was over for conceiving and bearing a son. But God said, I don't need fertility medicine. I don't need modern science. I'm God. I speak and it happens, Brother God. It's a miracle. Hey, who here tonight needs a miracle? Who here tonight needs a miracle? You may say, is the season past for my miracle? God doesn't work on the seasons of humanity. God works in divine order. And it could be your order to have your miracle. Now all of a sudden, between verse number 17 and verse number 18, years pass. It's like flipping the pages of the calendar and the years have passed. And the Bible says, when the child was grown, it fell on the day that he went out to his father, to the reapers. And he said to his father, my head, my head. And he said unto the lad, said to a lad, carry him to his mother. Here he is, he's complaining of his head hurting, he's out working with his father. I mean, he's not a boy anymore, he's not a toddler, but he's a young man. He's working in the field with his dad. And the Bible says that they took him to his mother. And as they took him to his mother, they laid that boy upon his mother's lap, and there he died. There he died. Brother David, I can't imagine that. The thought of bearing a child or bearing a young child, I just, it's hard to imagine. Brother Doug, for me on my job, when I see a child that's died, to look in the eyes of a pregnant child and see what should be just fervor and life, and to see that there's nothing in the eyes of the child that is past. And that woman is looking at that. It tugs my heart to me. There's never a time I don't walk away and shed tears or cry. I don't know them. I'm just allowed their moments. But here it is for Nancy. This is her son, and he's died. Can you imagine? God has given a promise, and we've enjoyed it, but now it dies. I wonder how that is with us tonight. What are the promises of God? Amen. The salvation of God. Sometimes we can allow the things of God to die in our life. Amen. Some of the things that God has worked and moved, you may say, it seems like it's dead. Listen, we are all too soon ready to throw in the towel when God wants us to trust Him with the valuable and the sacred and the precious and the miracles that He has done for us. Amen. So the Bible says that she called unto her husband and said, send me, I pray you, one of the young men and one of the asses, that I may run to the man of God and come to him. And he said, well, wherefore will you go to him today? It is neither new moon nor Sabbath. And she said, it shall be well. Now, there's a few things here that I want to look at. We never see Sister Tina. She never says to her husband, our son's died. I need to go to the man of God. She doesn't even breathe those words. She simply, Brother Craig, is looking for a miracle. When she knows when she gets to the prophet, she knows a miracle will be there. I think too often we all of a sudden call our neighbors and call our friends and we groan and we moan when all the time God is wanting us to pick up and by faith trust Him. We don't need to worry about the details. Amen. We don't need anything. Anybody else, what we need to do is find ourselves as quickly and expediently as we can in the presence of God that we may see things change and happen. Mm-hmm. It shall be well. I've shared this before, but this is amazing. The thought of getting in the presence of God, it shall be well. It shall be well. Keep that in your mind. The Bible says, then she saddled an ass and she said unto the servant, drive and go forward and slack not your riding for me, except I bid you. Amen. Here she is. Amen. She is going to the man of God for herself. I'm often, and I don't mind praying for anybody. Amen. But there's times in our life where you and I simply have to pray for ourselves. And here she is. She's not looking for her husband. She's not looking for a servant. She is looking herself. Amen. Yes, she got help. Amen. To make the journey. But she herself is making the journey to where the man of God is. God help us to petition the throne room of heaven for ourselves when we want to see God move. So she went and came to the man of God to Mount Carmel. And it came to pass that the man of God saw her afar off. And he said to Gehazi, his servant, behold, yonder is the shoe. Evidently he sees her from a distance and he recognizes her. He says to Gehazi, sir, he said, I want you to run to her, I pray you, and meet her. And say unto her, is it well with you? Is it well with your husband? Is it well with the child? And she answered, and she said, it is well. Immediately he knew that there was a problem. Amen. Why is this woman coming? Are you okay, lady? Is your husband okay? Is your son okay? A servant, go and ask him. God sees us even from a distance. And he recognizes us. He does, Brother Josh. He knows you. He knows me. He knows our needs. Because that's the kind of God he is. He's so familiar with us. The man of God saw you. And then she said this. She said, it shall be done. She's there in the presence of the need. Her son is dead. But she says, it shall be well. Do you know what changed the situation? Do you know why she can say, it is well, Sister Sandy? Because it is evidenced that faith is now the basis, Sister Jenny, by which she speaks. It is well. The Word of God says that if we have faith as the grain the size of a mustard seed, amen, we can say unto the mountain, be thou removed and cast into the sea. And though it's the smallest of all seeds, Jesus said, yet when it is planted, it brings forth this magnificent plant, Brother David, that all the fowls of the air can come and find a lodging place there. I'm here to tell you tonight, the difference that needs to be in our life, amen, is that we get in the presence of a mediator. There is one mediator between man and God, and that is the man Christ Jesus, amen. And when by eyes of faith we look at Jesus, amen, and we know that He's ever living to make intercession for us, amen, our problems, our struggles, the things that seem to be dead, the promises that seem to be broken, amen, when we get in the presence of God, we can say, it is well. Amen. I'm looking for a church tonight that will allow faith to rise up in their heart. Amen. And they can whisper those words, it is well. Amen. The thing that makes a difference is faith. Amen. The writer of Hebrews says, now faith is the substance or the title deed of things that is hoped for. Amen. It's a declaration of action. Hope is this. We don't see it. Amen. But the action is, I know that God is going to take care of it. Amen. God is able to be the great physician. God is able to be the provider. God is the revivalist. Amen. God is the soul saver. Amen. God is the builder of His kingdom. God is the one taking care of America. Amen. The deed says faith. Amen. Though I can't see it, I believe in it. And I will hope. I'll put action to it. Amen. Tonight, we've got hope. We've got to have faith. For by it the elders obtained a good report. We look at the Old Testament, we look at the New Testament, men and women who exercised faith, they obtained a good report. Through faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the Word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. Amen. I have to tell you this tonight. I don't sit around and try to figure out how the world was framed and fashioned, because I serve a God tonight. Amen. Would you listen? Amen. I serve a God. Amen. Amen. Who took nothing and created something. Amen. Something so magnificent. Something so detailed. Amen. If we trust Him tonight. Amen. He spoke the word and the worlds were framed. Amen. That's what faith does. Hallelujah. That is what faith does tonight. The Bible says it was by faith that Abel offered unto God a more excellent sacrifice, by which he obtained righteousness and was righteous. Amen. God testified of His gifts. It was by faith. The Word of God says that Enoch was translated that he should not see death. He did not see a formal death, but he went to be in the presence of God. It was faith. And I'm telling you, if you and I will have faith in the presence of God, it is well. The Word of God says, but without faith, it is impossible to please God. For he who comes to God must believe that He is, and that He, God, is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. The very foundation of our life should be this: is I have faith. And if I do not. Talk about your world being turned upside down, one child. I know this. I'll open myself up to criticism, but I'll just tell you, I can say, now I'm older. Now having girls, you know, I spoil them. I get them whatever I can within my means. Because I love them. I do. I love them. And sometimes, you know, they want to do something. I let them do it because I love them. I want them to enjoy. I don't want unruly children. They get discipline. Amen. They get timeouts. They get, you know, there's boundaries, Brother David. But I can. I love them. I want them to be happy. I want to do all that I can do for them. I think every good parent does. We have good parents in here. But here is one woman to the bottom of her world, just by the bottom of her family. But David, it didn't. She didn't speak about it. She didn't want to talk about it. All she wanted to talk about was getting into the presence of God. So we don't need to talk about the details of our life or the disappointments maybe that has happened to us or in our family or to those who are close to us. We don't need to talk about it. All we need to do is get to the presence of God and exercise some faith and say, God, in your presence, it is well. Amen. It is well. How can it be well when things have gone wrong? Because we have faith in God. The Word of God goes on down to say that Noah, being warned of God of things yet not seen. Amen. That there was a flood that was coming. Brother Doug, it was crazy. You all are aware of this. It never rained before. Amen. There was dew, some water from above, water from beneath, a worldwide flood. Amen. But because of God speaking to his heart, he didn't worry about the criticism of man. He worried about what God had told him, and by faith he held to it. I wonder tonight what God has spoken to your heart and to my heart. Amen. I was talking to Brother Ryan. I'm sure he wouldn't mind me sharing this. He was saying it to me. He said, God told me that my mom and dad would get saved. He gave me a vision. He gave me a dream. So I believe that God is going to do it. Sometimes we have to hold on to things like that. God just spoke to me. Amen. Just as you know, I remember you telling me about our girls. He said, God told me you're going to have a baby. God, I think you said, God told me two things before, and the first thing came through, and I know that God told me that. You held to that even when we were shaking. Amen. We've got to hold to what God promises us. Amen. Because God is faithful. Amen. Noah held to what God had promised him. We go on down, we read about Abraham who sojourns. He's going with us a lot. And Lot is building tents, but Abraham's building ours. He trusts God. And he looked for a city. His builder and maker was God. And God rewarded him. Sarah, she trusted God even though she slept. She trusted God. One man, but your seed will be as the stars of heaven, as the sand of the seashore. And then we read on down through the book, Hebrews chapter number 11, we read of Moses. Then let me talk to you about this lady quick tonight. What about a little lady named Rahab? Man, Brother David, if anyone should get heaven, should Rahab a harlot? But all the walls of Jericho, Sister Tina, there's just a red cord, a red thread that is left down. Sister Sandy, sometimes all we can hold to is a little thread of hope. And that's exactly what Rahab did. She dropped down that red thread, that red cord of hope. And it was counted to her as faith, and her life was spared. Listen tonight, I want to tell someone in sanctuary, maybe all you have to hold on to in a particular situation is a little thread of hope. Hope is the action of faith. And when God sees our faith, amen, it's accounted to us for righteousness. Amen. And God is a rewarder of those who seek Him and put their faith and their trust in Him. The Bible says that the man of God, amen, he said to his servant Gehazi, go ahead, I want you to take my cane, I take my staff with you, I want you to place it upon. I don't know what all that's about, but one thing I wonder, I think, is it ritualism? Brother Josh, was it some type of ritualism that they put a cane upon him? It didn't do anything. Listen, religion, ritualism won't do anything for us. Then came the man of God. The Bible says that he leaned on the child. His mouth upon the child's mouth. And the child's body waxed warm. And then, Jesus Christ loves us so much that he gave himself for us. Brother Craig, he lays upon us and says, listen, I'm going to breathe life into the dead and hopeless situations.
Have faith.
The boy. And he says to his mother, "Come get her." Oh, she comes. She bowed down. She was so thankful for what the man of God. When we exercise faith in a living God, He brings death to life. He makes impossible possible. Amen. He gives to us. And what can we do about that? Thank you. So I really feel in my heart tonight that I don't have church to have church. It's not why I'm here. We can do that anyway. Tonight I come because I truly believe God wants someone to have faith for a situation. It's so simple, but it's hard. Simply cannot see it. So tonight it's not about sin, but it's about trusting into a God who is able to do. And allowing the action of our faith to begin to hope that God can work and move in our situation. Maybe you've been thinking, I'm a believer, I'm faithful, I'm trusting God. It shall be well, it shall be well, it shall be well. Tonight, I invite you to make a journey to where God is. We have an altar. And then I'm inviting you to a piece of furniture in our building, but it's representative of an altar called Jesus Christ. Sister Nancy, that altar is anywhere, whether we bend our knee, whether we bend our heart, whether we're laying on our flat on our back, we have an altar in Jesus Christ. And when we come to that altar, when we look at Him, we can say, Mr. Beth, if you come to me out tonight, I'm believing this year for souls to be saved in this church. I'm going to be at the altar because it is well. God is going to save souls. I'm looking for God to fill with the Holy Ghost in this church. Listen, we see, I don't want this to sound harsher. But I'm going to be transparent. Black light is wonderful. You see all the people we touch, tons and tons of people. Just so many people. But unless the real message of the gospel gets to their heart, it's entertainment. What we need now is for God to deal with people and save them. His word. Some folks will say, well, it's foolish preaching. Yes, the Word of God says that the foolish are preaching and are saved. We're going to keep preaching the gospel throughout the church. We're going to keep on preaching the Word. It's the fence that's around us. We're going to keep on preaching the Word because it's what washes. And when folks feel wore out and dismayed, we're going to keep preaching faith. That is driven by the action of hope, so that we can see God move the mountains and cast them to the sea. The world needs you tonight. As much as you need God to move, the world needs you to have God move, so that they can see the power of the gospel. So tonight, you're in a learning situation, Sister Nancy. Each of us are. We win because faith moves God to work for us. And then Brother Doug, as he moves for us, it shows a world around us how powerful our life is. And have some folks who'll gather in tonight and get in the presence of God and say, it is well. Let's gather here tonight.